Wrestling midgets, fun for the entire family on all occasions, Gino Brito, and as you said at the beginning of this videotape, something with which you are so well familiar because it was really your father who created midget wrestling.
That's right. There was a time when we had 24 midget wrestlers going all across America. And right there, you're looking at Lil Brutus. He was one of the pioneers and is still going strong today, going up against a newcomer by the name of Sonny Boy from Yamashish, Quebec. Should prove interesting. The experience, I'll go with Brutus. For endurance, right now, you got to go with the youth and Sonny Boy.
Well, as you said, Lil Brutus unquestionably has been around and is, in a way, a throwback to the great era of midget wrestling, with midget wrestlers such as, and the first name that always comes to mind, of course, is Little Beaver.
That's right, Little Beaver, one of the greats with Sky Lalonde, and I'll tell you one thing, Brutus belonged in that category.
Jamaica Kid, another of the great ones of a bygone era. It's great to have, let's say, these fellas who bridge the various generations, and Little Brutus, as you will see, unquestionably still going strong, laying in some good right hands. These guys really are muscular and strong individuals, just short in stature, wouldn't you say, Gino?
That's right, they are. Oh.
Well, there's one of the reasons why wrestling fans the world over do enjoy watching these fellas in that ring. They like to mix in the comedic elements with the athleticism that's so obvious.
That's right. Midgets do entertain people a lot, and it's good to see them after you've seen the Abdullah the Butchers, all that gory blood. I just think that match we just seen between Dino Bravo and Abdullah, how tough it was, and poor Eddie Creechman, the beating he took. It's nice right now to relax and watch the midgets.
Well, you need a break from all that intensity because there's more to come as well.
Right on. I know we're going to have the Samus coming up against Dino Bravo, which would be interesting. But right now, let's get back to these midgets and see what the outcome will be.
Well, Sonny Boy very unceremoniously tossed out of the ring onto the floor on his posterior. And can see he's crawling through and underneath the ring. Little Brutus neglected to go right over to the ropes and check out the whereabouts of Sonny Boy, and the fans aren't letting him in on the secret that Sonny Boy is indeed back inside the ring and stealthily sneaking up behind him. He thinks it's the referee tapping him on the shoulder. Whoa! What a way to turn around. Good morning, Little Brutus. Oh, you know something, Gio? Only these fellas could accomplish what we just saw. And the interesting aspect of it, the fans didn't give Brutus a hint at all that Sonny Boy had gone under the ring and come back in.
That's right. Midget wrestling is a lot different, I think, from the bigger boys. Like right now,
Little Brutus
doing
like his road work.
He likes to showboat a lot, entertain the fans. That's what he's doing right now.
He's doing his road work right now. And I, ha ha ha, Little Brutus, he just couldn't run another mile, Gino.
He couldn't really. I mean, he was going back and forth, and Sonny Boy just watching him go, you know, like running through a park.
Well, I've never heard Little Brutus referred to as Mr. Perpetual Motion before, but he certainly was there. We saw some good rights laid in by Sonny Boy. Oh, a nice move, taking Little Brutus over the count going in, but a two count only. Well,
Okay, these guys do like to showboat, like I mentioned before,
but
they do have a knowledge of wrestling.
Oh, they sure do. And I'll tell you something, it is no picnic being inside that ring. As the man with the striped shirt, I don't know if to say if I was fortunate or unfortunate enough to have refereed midget wrestlers on a couple of occasions. And I'll tell you, they can not only make you look absolutely foolish, but they move.
I think they love to make somebody look foolish.
Yes, they do.
Especially the man with the striped shirt.
No question of that. Whoa, what a right hand Sonny Boy just received from Little Brutus, putting him flat on the canvas, whipped again, knee to the midsection, and Sonny Boy is over and down. Little Brutus showing us the benefit of his years of experience. What a scoop slam. And now, holding Sonny Boy up by the tights. The count of three. Well, the referee can't and doesn't have eyes in the back of his head because of the camera angle. We had benefit of seeing that Little Brutus used a little bit of chicanery and subterfuge to win that match by pulling on the tights of Sonny Boy. And accordingly, those years of experience did him well as he was victorious over Sonny Boy. Let's take another peek. Well, we just saw that very, very good knee to the midsection of Sonny Boy after he was ripped off the ropes by Little Brutus. And there's an exhibition of strength, slamming Sonny Boy. A flying sit, I guess, is the only thing you can call it. He hooks the tights. It's 1, 2, 3. Little Brutus wins this match.